Hello, my name is Leonard Isaacson. I've been in law enforcement 22 plus, maybe 23 years. Currently on with Naples City Police Department.
My name's Luke Lassiter. I'm an agent with adult probation and parole in Vernal, Utah. I've been doing this for working in corrections for about 6 years or so, something like that. And for the last few years, I've managed the offenders that are on drug court in Yuna County.
My name is Mike Gledhill. I've been an officer for 14 years in the state of Utah. I'm employed by the Vernal City Police Department. I'm currently the canine sergeant for our patrol division, and I'm also the supervisor of the Uinta Basin Narcotics Strike Force. I've been with the Strike Force for a little over 7 years, and three I've been the supervisor, which consists of agencies from Vernal City, Uinta County, Naples City, Duchesne County, and Roosevelt.
Hello, my name is Trevor Irish, and I am a mental health therapist for adult probation and parole. I also have an opportunity to also provide therapy in the private sector.
I've been asked to speak about the opioid issue here in the basin, and it's not an issue, it's an epidemic that we're facing, not only in the basin, but statewide and nationwide.
And something I've noticed recently is there's a lot of people applying to get into drug court or who are in drug court that are under the age of 25. 18 years old was just the youngest person that's applied to get in. And the huge majority of these people have heroin addictions. I find it interesting that the young crowd that's doing it. A lot of the older offenders that are in drug court, you know, 30 years and older, heroin's just not very common. It's other things, but the younger kids, that's what it is. And a lot of them have started around the age 12, 13, 14, getting into drugs. And there's some that are marijuana, and that's kind of normal, but there's also a lot of them, it's prescription medications that they've gotten from grandma or grandpa or mom or dad. And they get into that, and they go as long as they can, but oftentimes, you know, these teenagers don't have jobs, and how are you supposed to go to a doctor and get them to prescribe you opiates? So it's easier to turn the street and get heroin. It's
specifically here in the basin, approximately 6 or 7 years ago, we saw an increase of people from the ages of 16 and up abusing either prescribed painkillers that were issued to them or buying painkillers off the streets from a drug dealer. After about 2 years of that, seeing the increase of pills on our streets, we started seeing heroin for the first time in my experience. Prior to that, here in the basin, started after the pills increase, we saw the heroin increase, and that's just kind of a natural progression. Unfortunately, when people become addicted to painkillers, Oxycontin, oxycodone, it becomes quite expensive. For us as a task force utilizing confidential informants, we were buying pills for $40, $50 a pill. The natural progression would be heroin, a point of heroin, which is 0.01 grams, so very little, was costing $10. So people with that addiction to painkillers started turning to heroin for a cheaper and similar high, and that's when we really saw the explosion of heroin here in the basin, and we've been combating it since.
I was asked to talk a little briefly about opiates with young adults and adolescents. Now, in the private sector, I deal with a lot of adolescents, and I deal with a lot of opiate issues. You can always tell if someone is having an addictive issues based off of three criteria. Here are the three criteria. One, you'll notice their appetites. You'll notice that they will reduce their willingness, their wants, or even their need for food, especially with opiates. Two, and this is kind of a two-folded two, their depression. If someone has no desire to get out of bed, they're sleeping a lot, they're very lethargic, they have no energy, and their moods also taper into a negative part. Also, you can also look at the anxiety aspect of that as well. They will withdraw from family gatherings, they will draw from social groups, their social circle. Some cases I have seen with adolescents that their grades will drop. They don't really have a desire to get involved in school activities like they did at one time. And I think we need to clarify something here that when you're talking about opiates, everybody's different. Everybody's body is created different in the aspect of chemicals. So some who have opiate issues may see a totally negative side of things we've been talking about, and others could see a positive side. And let's clarify, there's nothing positive about drugs, but when we're talking about on the positive side, they may feel energetic, they may feel like a form of euphoria, they may feel that life is great, they don't feel any negative emotions or any stress or just life stressors.
How do we know when our kids are addicted to drugs? You know what your children are like. They're gonna have a personality change, a big one. They're gonna start hanging out with a crowd of people that they don't normally hang out with. You start seeing some defiance in them that you hadn't seen before, or some attitudes being manifested that draws you that alarm, that concern. You're going to, as a parent, overlook some of these things, thinking it's just growing pains, but it very well could be drug addiction. Could ramble for hours, I'd imagine, if I had a more specific point other than to say this. Out of my lifespan of 47 plus years and a little over 23 years in law enforcement, that opioid addiction is one of the hardest addictions to get rid of. When I say hardest, it's the one that we deal with mostly.
Just the other day, someone was telling me that when we take them to jail for drug court violations and drug uses and stuff like that, if they were using methamphetamine, it usually takes them about 3 or 4 days, and they get that out of their system and kind of those cravings go away. However, with opiates, especially heroin, which is kind of gone rampant around here, those 3 days in jail aren't working because they get out and they still have that deep craving to go out and use immediately, and then they do. They get out and within hours, they're high again. But it seems to me that a heroin addiction is more difficult for people to get out of than other addictions.
And my biggest suggestion would be, obviously, to parents to make sure and lock up your prescription pills. If you're prescribed any pain pills as a parent, make sure that's in a lockbox so your teenagers, your juveniles in your household don't have access to that. And if you have a child, a juvenile that's been prescribed painkillers, I would watch them closely and make sure that that doesn't become an issue and they're not abusing those prescriptions and taking them as so. And then once they've either healed from their injury and no longer need the opioids, or you still have that excess bottle, please take that to one of the areas that you can and destroy those narcotics. Specifically, I know the Uinta County Public Safety Complex, right through the front doors, has a dispensary where you can dump those pills in. That way, that's just not accessible. Kids have the internet, kids hear things at school, and they hear things about a heroin, and that's talking middle school, junior high, and high school, and that takes out that temptation of having that accessible to those young people.
What can you do as a parent to help keep your kids away from that potential addiction? When they are prescribed it, make sure they're only taking that prescription as is prescribed by the doctor. Also understand you can request some drugs that are non-narcotic analgesics, which means synthetic or a narco that's not addicting. In that fashion, what you're doing is you're making it that attempt as a parent concept of overdoing the drugs or becoming addicted to them is less likely to happen. Also, they're seeing you take those pills and your pills, and the pain goes away, and so they might decide to do a little self-medication. And in that self-medication, taking prescriptions for an adult, for a child, first time, if they take that normal prescription the adult take, they're going to experience that overdose, that separation from pain, separation in their mind of reality, and from that point on, that addiction has started. Take your medication and lock it up. Besides the fact that removes the kids from access to it, it makes you the person that handles it out to them so that they can utilize it as prescribed. And more importantly, if you do lock it up, there's also some outside criminal activity that when someone breaks into your house, or maybe it's not your kids, it's the neighbor's kids coming over and visiting, if it's locked up, they're not going to get into your medication. And that's also a deterrent from people becoming an addict at that point. When you see it, don't just discard it. Address it. Figure out where the chain's coming from. And encourage them to hang out with the people they want to emulate, those people they want to become more like.